Hello, dear students and all kinds of viewers. Assalamu alaikum. I hope you are enjoying your days in the home, though it's a very crisis moment of our life. We have all been suffering from pandemic. In spite of all these things, actually, we are not away from our classes. And like before, I have come here again with a different class with you. That is, this class has mainly made and prepared for HSC first year students. And as you all know me, I am Mazharul Haq, assistant professor of English, Kumila Victoria Government College, and I would like to warmly welcome you at this PowerPoint presentation session. Thank you very much. So let's get started. This is the book that you will be following. So what I would like to remind you, dear students, is that you will have to bring the book with you and open at page 68 to follow the lecture. Okay, dear students, what can you see in this image? This is the image of a university abroad, and this is a very one of the famous universities of the world. So what can you think about this university? I think you are quite right. We are going to talk about higher education in Bangladesh and elsewhere in the world. And look at this frame of pictures. These are the universities of different regions of the world, the prestigious universities of the whole world, and well-known universities ranked high. At the top left corner, University of Technology Sydney. Top right corner, University of Oxford. Bottom right corner, University of Nottingham, Malaysia. And bottom left corner is, Boston University of USA. So these are all the universities. What does this image indicate or reflect? This image, can you guess anything? And I hope you are correct. These images actually tell you that we are going to talk about higher education in Bangladesh and also its throughout the whole world and its impact upon the students. So let's go to the next slide. And as you all know, this man, the world poet Rabindranath Tagore, and I think after looking all these slides, you have come to something has come to your mind, that what are we going to talk about? Yes, we are going to talk about a chapter, unit 6, lesson 1, which is actually and solely written by Rabindranath Tagore. And Rabindranath Tagore was born in 1861, died 1941. Let's go to the next slide. This is the right slide that we are going to talk about the whole session, Path to Higher Education and Stern University. This topic is solely written by Rabindranath Tagore, Unit 6, Lesson 1. So I would like to welcome you this lesson, and I hope you will enjoy listening and watching this activity very carefully and with full concentration. Okay, before we go deeper into the topic, can you just think about the title for 1 minute and explain it with your own language? That path to the higher education. What is path? Path means a way. Actually, it will take you to somewhere else. It will lead you to somewhere else. It's a path. It will take you to the destination. That's called path. So this unit, Path to Higher Education, will definitely lead you to reach your goal in the life and bring you success. Well, we have actually entered into our lesson, and let's have a look at this. What is the present state of Eastern University? First, dear students, it's a long chapter. There are a lot of passages in this chapter, so it's not possible to see and read line by lines. I would like to show you the glimpse and important topics, important ideas from this chapter. So let's have a look at this. What is the present state of Eastern University? According to Rabindranath Tagore, actually, the present state of Eastern University is very shabby and in a very dire consequence. It has dire effects upon it. So what does it do? It only collects and distributes knowledge, have become India's arms bowel of knowledge, lower our intellectual self-respect, teach us only to borrow, not to create anything, lead us to pass exam only and make only qualified candidates, only provide external success, do not relate to culture. So these are some drawbacks or some pitfalls of the Eastern University that has been chalked out in this passage. Let's go to the next slide. But what it should be like actually, an Eastern University and all the world-class universities should have some duties to follow. What are they? Teachers should provide intellectual hospitality or welcome mind. Students have to acquire inner perfection. Students need to develop creativity. All learners should follow culture. Education has to be built based on this culture. So these are the targets. These are the outcomes of a university. Let's have a look at the next slide. These are very important things. I mean, if you want to read the whole chapter, you have to be acquainted with the vocabularies or the keywords, which are very important for you to know. Dear students, let's have a look at them one by one. Actually, I have designed it in such a way so that you can see the parts of speech, synonyms, and also the meaning. So it will be very much helpful for you. Let's start with the first one, intellectual. Intellectual is an adjective or it can be used as a noun. It means noetic, rational, associated with or acquainted, the use of mind, having intellect. Next one, acquainted. It's an adjective. It's mean familiar, known, having fair knowledge of something. Succumb. Succumb is a verb. It means yield, give in, surrender, consent reluctantly, yield to a force. Grudge is a verb, very uncommon word for you, I think, and it can be also used as a noun. The synonyms are big grudge, recent grievance, harbor ill feelings, long-term animosity. Next one, compulsion, it's a noun. It means obligation. These are the synonyms, obligation, constraint, irrational need, or irresistible urge to perform action or to do something. Aristocracy, it's of course a noun. It means nobility, peerage, nobility or hereditary ruling class or elite class. Hospitality, it's a noun. Friendliness, welcome, helpfulness, and the meaning is act of welcoming, receiving, entertaining guests. The last one of this slide is claimant. It's a noun, one who claims something, suitor, applicant, or candidate. So there are some more vocabularies. I would like to discuss them one by one. Dear students, first one is excellence. It's a noun, means superiority, perfection, worth, quality of being excellent or brilliant. Mechanical is an adjective. Lifeless, mindless, acting as if performed by a machine. Next one is proportion. Proportion means, proportion is a noun or it can also be used as a verb. Part, portion, percentage, bit, ratio, a part, a share, considered in a comparative relation to a whole. Next one is lure. Lure is a verb. Or it can be used as a noun, temptation, enticement. Humiliation, it's a noun, embarrassment, shame, disgrace, ignominy. Perversity is a noun, it means willfulness, obstinance, tenacity, awkwardness, willful desire to behave in unreasonable or unacceptable way. Maxim, it's a noun. Its synonyms are saying, adage, proverb, motto. Okay, the last one is trampled. It's an adjective. It means treated. I mean stepped down or stamped, crushed, walked over, stepped heavily on something or someone, causing damage or injury. So these are all the vocabularies, dear students, that you will have to learn or you need to know, need to be familiarized with, because in order to proceed further of this unit, you will have to have a very clear idea and conception about these vocabularies. Now we are going to the next slide. Moving forward, pre-reading questions. Very important. The pre-reading questions are important because it will give you a hint of the passage or comprehension passage that we are going to talk about today. So what are the pre-reading questions? And it has been given to you. What do teachers do in an Indian university? Has Indian education always been like this? Why Indian universities are thought to be M's bowl? What should university actually do for the nation? Why are the intellectuals not doing the right thing? So dear students, while conducting the lesson and while you will be understanding the lesson, you will be thinking about the pre-reading questions, which I will follow at the end of the slide. Okay, this is a very important slide because this will give you the main ideas of the comprehension passage. Because it's not possible to read the whole passage line to line or word to word. So I would like to give you the main ideas or summary of the comprehension passage, which will be very helpful for you to understand the whole comprehension passage. So let's have a look at this. According to Rabindranath Tagore, the main objective of our universities should be to keep continuing on research for creating knowledge, introducing students with our culture, and developing a tradition in which teachers and students can offer their intellectual hospitality and also their wealth of mind to others. They can also serve intellectuals to earn their proud right in return to receive gifts from the rest of the world. These are shortcomings of the universities established in India in the modern times. These universities borrow knowledge from foreign countries and do not present any knowledge in return. By doing this, they actually lower our intellectual self-respect by encouraging us to make a show of borrowed knowledge. Universities should never be made into mechanical organizations for collecting and distributing knowledge only because they have far greater responsibilities than this. They should also discover the best things of the world, of a nation's mind, and develop their intellectual culture and acquaint students with the best things they can provide. They should make the community not only educated, but also cultured. So this is the main idea of the whole comprehension passage of this unit, lesson 1. I hope you have seen this, and I have tried to highlight the most important words or keywords from this passage so you can get some idea in a different way. Let's go to the next slide. Core meaning and message from the text. Actually, of course, every text or every unit has a core meaning or, you know, as a message from the writer. So it's no exception. So what is the message that has been given to us? Or it can be called a theme. The writer has tried to express something in an indirect manner. What is that? Let's read it out. Universities shouldn't be an organization for producing graduates and intellectuals only, nor it should be a place for conducting research and writing journals alone. Rather, universities should focus mainly on producing quality graduates and encourage further research activities so as to make intellectuals to usher a change in the mechanical attitudes of the mentality of the people. The universities must be vigilant enough to sustain the traditional concepts of the society and nourish the culture in such a way so that the intellectuals can be needed for the upgradation of the society and culture. Best practices from other universities can be followed and imitated for constructive changes in the society. Finally, the graduates and intellectuals passing out from the universities should contribute to the nation building activities and serve to the welfare of positive societal changes of the country. So, dear students, there is a core meaning and message from the text which I have tried to establish so that you can get the glimpse and taste of whole passage just in one paragraph. And I hope you have seen this and you have tried to understand this. Let's go to the next slide. Now is the time to remembrance or recall. Can you remember that I have given you some pre-reading questions? Do you remember the pre-reading questions? If yes, try to answer them, or you can discuss it with your partner, because the pre-reading questions are very much helpful for you to get the whole idea of the unit, of this unit. Okay, there are some follow-up questions which I would like to give you as a tutorial. That is, when you study at home, you'll try to work with these questions in order to get sufficient idea about the passage and also to solve some other exercises like the flowchart or the fill in the blanks or to write down a summary. So these are very important questions for you, which can be helpful for your exercise. So what are the follow-up questions? First one, what according to Rabindranath Tagore should be the aim of our universities? Number two, what is the shortcoming of the universities established in India in the modern times? Number three, universities should never be made into mechanical organizations for collecting and distributing knowledge. Why? Number four, why according to Rabindranath the disaffection has become widespread among the educated community? Number five, what should universities never be? Number six, what is culture acknowledge? And the last one, why has the writer compared Indian universities to Am's bow? So these are really very important questions, dear students and viewers, because this question will give you a very good idea about the whole unit. I mean, unit one, lesson one, and what is the, you know, the theme, what is the focal point, and what does the writer actually want to express throughout the whole sections. And that's it from me. Hope you have enjoyed the whole session. And I have tried to give you the glimpse of the total unit. And if you have any kind of trouble or any kind of query, any difficulty in understanding the unit, you are very much welcome to email me. My email number has been given at the very first slide, mazhar.hook@gmail.com. And so it's all from me today. Thank you very much. See you again at the day. Until then, goodbye.